Hi everybody, I'm Jack Niland. I'm a UX designer at Spacecraft and I work with our clients to create usable, accessible websites. So today we're just going to do a little bit of a talk about accessibility and why it's important. So web accessibility is about removing barriers so that everyone and anyone can access the web. And whether we're department heads, developers or content creators, we've all got a responsibility to offer an inclusive and above all, usable experience for whoever comes to our site. So if accessibility isn't in your digital strategy, it should be. So everyone has a right to a web that they can use and one that they can use independently. If we want our users to effectively engage with our websites and return to use more of our website's services, it needs to be accessible. So accessibility guidelines help us to understand the different ways that people use the web or the different types of technology that they can use. The Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, or WCAG, are one such set of guidelines that we use to help us create and test our products and sites. You may have heard of these, and earlier in the year, there was an upgrade to 2.1. So what 2.1 is, well, first of all, it's backward compatible. So all of the guidelines we used to have in 2.0 still apply, and 2.1 just adds a few more. So 2.1 is great because it focuses much more on modern user habits like mobile use and more modern design trends on the web. So we're just going to talk about a couple of guidelines in 2.1 and what they mean. First of all, 1.3.4, orientation. So that one is quite simple. All it means is the orientation of your website must not be fixed at portrait or landscape on your mobile. So it's quite simple. Another one, 1.3.5, identify input purpose. So what that means in plain English, the input purpose is what the form is asking you. So if it's asking you for your name, the input purpose is to find out your name. So when you have autofill options on your browser already knows your name, so you don't have to type it in. You get that handy little box that you can click and it'll fill out the whole thing for you. So the purpose of this guideline is saying that if the import purpose can be identified, it should, so that users don't have to type out all of those details, or however they may interact with the website. So that ties in with some existing guidelines like the headings and labels guideline or the labels and instructions guideline. So these examples can be a great benefit to someone who has a cognitive or mobility disability, but they're also good examples of how accessibility can benefit all of us. So making your site accessible isn't just for the designer or the developer. It should be at the forefront of your mind at any point in the life cycle of your products. So for example, even the way you write your content will have an impact on accessibility. So one really simple way you can make accessible headings, for example, is to put all of the most important information at the start. So not only is this quicker for us to read, it's also quicker for people using assistive technology like screen readers or voice input. So they're just a few examples of how accessibility can help.